Less than 15 miles from the North Sea, Ipswich has long established naval links, and in 1933, the Royal Hospital School moved here from its original location in Greenwich. Teachers Monty Callow and Rob Mann have been involved with the school for 63 years between them.
The school was founded in 1712, and it was essentially set up for the sons of naval personnel. The school is currently just over 700 pupils, girls and boys. There are still quite a lot of naval bursaries still at the school, but it's obviously changed a lot over the last 300 years.
I came to the school in 1967 as an 11-year-old boy. My father was in the Royal Navy. I then returned here to teach, became head of science, and retired last year.
But he keeps coming back.
I know.
Hello there.
Hi.
Drew.
How are you doing?
Good to meet you.
I am T.
Hi, T.
Drew.
Monty.
Monty.
How are you?
Hi, T.
Blimey. This place is huge.
It is, it is. Yeah.
It's enormous.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Sorry, I can't contain myself. I need to have a look around.
Yeah, well,
love all the paintwork up here.
It's fabulous. Yeah, it's only 1933, actually.
I know. Still looks the part, doesn't it?
It does.
Yeah.
So, do you want to come off and have a look at a few?
I believe you've got quite a lot for us to see.
Yeah, it's a big site as
and
well.
And it's spread all over the site.
Great. Oh, let's go.
Yeah.
Let's get started. Blimey! Look at the size of this place.
Yeah, it's bigger. It used to be bigger, actually.
It's a whopper. Love the colour scheme on the panelling. Very nice.
Yeah.
There's no sausage on a fork flying through the air.
There will be. We'll bring that on later for you. First impressions when I arrived here is literally the scale of the place. It's incredible. It's vast. It's absolutely enormous. And we haven't even seen half of it. For my entire time working with antiques, schools have always been a rich source. They buy in a big way because they have to. With a place this big, who knows, today we could find all sorts. Hopefully a lot of all sorts.
We're off to Hood boarding house. It's girls' boarding house.
Yep.
About 60 girls. And got a few tables in there, so...
Good. That's what I'm hoping for.
Right, OK. This is the surf shack.
Ah, right, OK. These are them.
Yeah. Well, yeah, this is the table here.
And bench underneath as well.
There's two benches under there. There's one on the far side.
Great. Can I move all this stuff?
Yeah, we can get this off, yeah. Pull it out,
do you want to get a...
Are they teak?
Oak.
That's oak. Or what about these?
And that's teak.
Yeah.
They're teak, are they?
Yeah. All the joints have gone on these. How many of these have you got?
As of now, there's just one.
It's going to have to come apart.
Shouldn't be hard to fix, is it? Or...
Well, it's a day in the workshop.
A bit of labor.
It's a day in the workshop, yeah.
I mean, it's 1933.
Yeah.
It's...
350 quid.
I think 350 is probably a bit lower than I was thinking.
Well, yes and no. Without this...
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a problem. But what about these, then? How many of these have you got?
Well, I've got a few of those.
Rob's now showing me something that I really wanted to find here today, and this is nice, big oak refectory tables. And the bonus is it has benches with it. Good, solid workmanship. But what they also are is very desirable, and they're very usable. So they can go anywhere. They can go into restaurants, but they can also go into family homes.
This early to mid 20th century 18-seater refectory table has tapered legs and was made in England from thick hand-cut planks of wood. Refectory tables were originally used for communal dining in monasteries in medieval times, before gradually being adopted by castles and grand residences for their great feasts. Also on offer are 8 mismatched benches. Once refurbished, the table could be worth around £1,000. And the benches around £200 each.
75 a bench?
75. I mean, I'll tell you what, before you came, I was thinking sort of about 500 and about 150
each,
I have to say.
Yeah, I can't quite get to there because of the condition.
I mean, I think 150 is one of those. I mean, it's teak.
Are you want 150 each?
Yeah.
It's not going to happen.
What were you offering?
75.
75 for two?
No, each.
I would say £200 the pair if you went 500 on the table.
I'm not going to go 500 on the table.
What'd you reckon?
I went at 350, 400.
So you're looking at 400 and 100 each.
I'd like to buy more of the benches. I'd like to buy all of the benches.
I mean, I'd go 125 on the benches if we sold more of them to you, because I think that's a...
I'll buy them all for 100 quid a bench. That's better.
I've got eight benches.
800
quid. 1,000 on it. 1,400 with this.
Are they all the same benches in the same condition?
Yes. 1,400. Okay,
deal.
Good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Things that we buy from schools always have one common denominator. In fact, no, they have two. They've got chewing gum all over them, and they're beaten to hell. The joints are all creaking and broken. These are simple dowels, peg joints. So what we have to do is take the top off, then drill the dowels out and redo them and re-glue them. No, it takes time. There's work to do. There's a good day, maybe a day and a half on that one table to sort it out. But after that's done, it's a good saleable item.
The school and its grounds are set across 200 acres of land. With so much space to explore, Rob and Monty have picked out a few items they hope Drew will be interested in.
Is this the stand you want me to have a look at?
Yeah, there's a stand here that this is Debbie's art class room.
You're not using it or don't want it?
It's not been used for its original purpose for some time.
But it's quite a heavy one, this one, quite a heavyweight one.
It is, yeah.
This 1950s steel sculpture stand has a timber top. Artists would create their artwork on the wooden platform. The adjustable height and rotating top giving them flexibility to reposition the sculpture as required. Once restored, it could be worth around £200.
What would you want for it?
I mean, what do you reckon, Debbie? £100?
125.
125? You do 125?
No. No, Fred. No, I can't, I'm afraid.
What about 100?
About 100.
You can do 100, can you?
Yeah.
OK.
That's
ideal.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks for that.
Yeah. Thanks, Monty. Sculptor stands traditionally sell really well, particularly the old timber ones. The steel ones take a bit more shifting, but they'll go eventually.
All right, so this is our design tech.
Wow. You've got a hell of a setup here, haven't
you?
This is what you want me to look at, yeah?
Yeah, we've got some old original lab stools there. I think the two metal ones are really cool, actually. Whoa.
Have you got hundreds of these?
No. Well, there are others around. There's five there.
OK. Just interested in these two.
Yeah, they are nice, actually,
yeah.
aren't they?
Bit of work. Nothing major. I want to leave the original timbers on them, leave them as is.
We've now gone into the CDT department and there are some work stools there. Nice, simple piece of design, nice wear, good colour on the timber on the top, and just about the right size as well.
These low-rise steel stools are wooden-topped and of tubular construction. They date from the 1970s and could be worth around £70 per stool.
What do you want for them?
Again, up to you, really. I mean,
50 quid a pair.
75?
60?
65.
55?
65. It's a deal.
We stumble across three more of the same stools.
If they're available, I'll take those as well.
Paid 165 for the five, that's about right.
Well done.
Today has been really interesting. There's so many rooms here, I think we've probably done 5%. If that of the building. But what we have found have all been really good items with a nice little provenance.
It was great to meet both Drew and T.
Fantastic experience. I enjoyed the repartee, the negotiations. I think we were a good match and I think things ended up in the right place.
I left it all to Rob because I'm too soft.
I think overall it's been a positive experience, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Very good.